Hey guys, this is Adrian from AdrianFX.com and this tutorial is sponsored by ArtBeats.com. Hey guys, I know lately I've been so busy I'm not able to post regular videos, but now I try to post more videos. And this is an update video of my 3D tracking, because a lot of you guys requested for an advanced version or update version of 3D camera tracking. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you few cool ways how can you refine your track and how can you basically able to get most accurate data. So this video is provided by the ArtBeats.com. The link's in the description. Check them out. They are amazing. They're really amazing. So let me just show you this footage first. Okay. Let me just do it. And basically, I drop down the resolution so it will render fast. So as you guys can see, it's pretty dope footage, isn't it? Yeah, it is. So yeah, it's pretty cool. So what you're gonna do, we're going to lens distort, undistort this footage, and then camera track, then refine this, our camera tracking, and in the end we will going to make a point cloud. So first let's see, this is a 1080 footage, HD 1080. So first hit S and change the setting first. On default is in 2K, but we're going to change it to 1080 as this footage is. Yeah, so first we're going to undistort this footage. So we hit tab and type lens distortion, and over here you can see three different options: image analysis, grid analysis, and line analysis. In line analysis, basically we line up things, we make straight lines, and according to those lines software analyze the lens distortion. And in grid analysis, we film a checkerboard on this set, through this checkerboard we'll get distortion data on that checkerboard. So because of that checkerboard, it will analyze the distortion, which is pretty cool. And in image analysis, it analyzes the whole footage, and according to this footage, it will give you the lens distortion data. Basically, the most accurate data you will get in grid analysis, but we didn't have our checkerboard, so I'm going to use image analysis for the sake of this tutorial. So as you can see, we have two options over here: source and mask. So in source, we connected our footage, and in mask, I'm going to cut out this sky area because it's just a garbage. So I'm going to use a keyer to make a rough alpha for the sky. So I'm gonna make a quick rough alpha for my sky, and I'm going to use this alpha in my lens distortion as well as in my camera tracking. So and if you guys have any moving object in your scene, just mask them out. That will really help and give you the more accurate data. So and now I'm going to delete the lower portion. So I'm gonna make a rough roto shape layer. Sorry, roto. And I'm gonna skip this part because no one loves roto. So I'll meet you after this. Okay guys, so I done my roto stuff. So now I'm just gonna stencil this lower portion from my above area, so I will get a perfect black and white matte. So I'm gonna use merge node, hit M for merge node, and connect all this. On default it's on over, so just switch it on to stencil, and now you can see it subtracted that lower portion. So now we have a good black and white matte. So this one we're going to use in our mask layer, as in our mask layer. So just connect your mask and give him that alpha, and let me just line up this thing, align things. Okay, yeah. So now we have, we're gonna do image analysis, but first just going to mask and change it to mask alpha. You can over here, we just change to mask alpha. Now when we do this, now it's just gonna reject all the sky portion area, and it will give analyze the ground portion. So I'm gonna skip this part. Okay, so we then our on distortion. So as you guys can see, when I'm hitting D, you can see it undistorted our footage, which is pretty cool. So now we can do a camera tracking. So hit tab and right camera tracker. Now you can see over here we also have two sources, one source and one mask. So we give him its mask. Sorry guys. So over here you can see, let me just make some room. Yeah, so now you can see like we have a few options. Like in mask, we do the same, we give him the mask alpha. Okay, yeah, so it will just reject all the sky portion area, and we already done our lens distortion, so we just leave it on to default, no lens distortion. So but okay, so if you guys have your camera information, like your which lens you guys using on set of and which camera you have, so you can tell him that, and according to those information it will give you more accurate data. So let's jump into settings. So now you, by hitting preview features, you can see your feature points, and for example, let me just change none. So you can see now it's taking the sky portion area, but when I'm using the mask alpha, it rejecting those area because it's just a waste. So let me just increase the trap portion area. How about that, 300? Yeah, 300 will work fine. Yeah, it's looking pretty good. Yeah, so let me just crop the footage. Yeah, it's looking fine. So okay, so just go into your camera tracker and hit track. So it will track, it will take a few time. So I'll meet you after this short break. Okay, so we tracked our footage. Now we're gonna solve our camera. So hit solve to solve the camera, and it check few seconds, and yeah, it's solved. It's pretty fast. Okay, so yeah, our tracking is looking pretty cool. As you guys can see, like we have a really good point cloud. Yeah, okay. So but still we having like few red and orange marks, and we have our tracking error is more than one. It's like 1.25 and it's too high, and we basically recommend like below one. So what you're gonna do, we're going to refine our tracking. So just go into auto track. Over here we have like three options, like minimum length, maximum track error, and maximum error. So we're gonna refine from this. So okay, so first select your track length minimum and hit control and select minimum length. Okay, so let me just make some room first. Okay, so what you're gonna do in minimum length, we're just going to increase it just slightly above from the highest peak. Let me show you. Just increase this bar just slightly above from this highest peak, because you don't want to lose everything, you know. And it turned your few markers into red, but it's fine. That's what I'm doing. That's what we are doing. We are refining it. Okay, so in maximum track error, select your error RMS and hit control, select your maximum track error like this. Yeah, and let me just zoom in this. Okay, so what you're gonna do, basically we're going to delete all those spiky areas and give him like most average tracking, and it will turn a lot of your points into red. But so you have to see this, you don't push it too far, otherwise it will delete your all tracking points. And you can also hit F4 to see properly on your graph. Just hit F like this, and we're going to delete all those spiky areas basically. Yeah, and in maximum error, just select your error maximum and maximum error, and we're gonna do the same. We're gonna delete all those spiky areas and give him like most average tracking points. And after this, just delete your unsolved camera and delete your rejected points like this. Over here, you can just select your delete. Yeah, like this. It's so simple. Just delete and hit yes. And after this, yes. And now you guys can see we have our solving error is below 1, which is pretty cool. And that's what we want. So I'm gonna resolve my camera again. So I'll make sure that everything is working fine. And it takes a second, and yes, and it's really good. Yes, as you guys can see, it's below 1, which is cool. So now you guys can export your camera scene and project your thing, which will work fine. We still having few red markers, but it's fine for the sake of this tutorial. Okay guys, so you guys can see our ground is not set on ground plane or not grid. So what we're gonna do, we're going to tell the software, we're gonna select few points and tell the software that these points are the, basically these points are the ground plane. So we're gonna select few points that we think that those points are on ground, like this. We're gonna select those points and simply just hit right click. Let me find out a few more ones. Now I think it's for now on this frame is that's it. Okay, so just select right click ground plane and set you selected. Basically now I'm gonna scrub to this footage and select all those points that I think is on ground. So I'll meet you in a few seconds. Okay guys, I set it selected all those points and snap those points on the ground. And let me just zoom out a little bit so you guys can see properly. Now our ground is on place on this grid. Yeah, as you guys can see, the higher portion area is on the grid properly. I'm not sure you guys can see properly or not, but it's placed on ground, the higher area. Okay, so after this, you guys can simply export your camera and scene and project your thing. But what I really like to do after this, I make a point cloud, so which basically this thing really helps to align your card and 3D stuff in 3D space. So as you can see, we have like 3 things like source, mask and camera. So we're gonna connect our source into the lens distortion, the footage, and we give him a mask, and a camera. So we're gonna export a camera from here, and by default it's linked, but if you guys don't want this green link lines, just uncheck this and create your camera again. It's that same camera, but it just now didn't have that green light. Okay, so in your point cloud, just make ignore mask to mask alpha and analyze this footage. Just hit analyze, and after this, select the point track points. And I'm gonna skip this part because point cloud took time. So I'll meet you after a few minutes when I jump the analyzing and track points. Okay, it's getting slower now. Okay, now it started. So I'll meet you after a few minutes. Okay, guys. So we tracked our footage, and when I'm using the alpha, it's giving very, very weird results. So I retracked this footage and basically re-point cloud. I generated a new point cloud without alpha. That's why I'm having this sky portion. So, but we can also refine our point cloud. And for now, it's looking pretty good. Basically, it depends on you, on your project. So yeah, it's looking pretty fine. So we're going to try to solve this sky portion area and refine our point cloud. So when you go down below over here, you can see angle threshold and density threshold. So when you scrub to this, you guys can see it making few red mark points. So according to you, just don't push it too much, otherwise it will delete all your points. And when you think like yeah, it's fine, so just okay, so after this, when you satisfy your from this, just hit delete rejected points. It's looking fine. Okay, so just hit delete rejected points, and now it deleted all those points and it gave you this result. and it's looking pretty good for now for this tutorial. It's fine. Basically, every footage is different and you never know what happened next. It's just a software. And in the end, it's just a software. No matter how much you get rigged, you should always check positive and learn by your mistakes. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video as it took a lot of hard work to prepare it. Seriously, it took. If you can be kind enough to leave a like and share this video so everyone can see this, that would be great, appreciated. If you have a suggestion as a what tutorial I do next or how can I improve my videos more, please leave a comment down below. If you're new here and you like what you saw, don't hesitate to subscribe. Yes, subscribe now. Follow me on my social medias, all the links in the description. And that's all for today. And thank you guys for watching. My name is Arjun, but you call me HM. And I'll see you next time when I find out how to get $1 billion. Thank you guys. Bye bye.